So now, since you know most of the things about Reddit marketing, I have shared a list of few tools that you can use to enrich your Reddit marketing experience. So let's have a look at them. Okay, so the first tool that we'll be discussing is called Snoopsu. And with this tool, what you can do is you can research on other marketing accounts, and you can also get a handle on what content works best and maybe more importantly, what content doesn't work. So let's visit their website. This is their website, and suppose we want to analyze any Reddit account. So I'll write here Martin Tech 123. So let's try to analyze this profile and let's see what we get out of this tool. Great. So now here we have a summary of this particular Reddit account, and it's showing us that Redditor is active since this particular date, and longest period between two consecutive posts is 9 months. So how active the user is, we can see it from here. Then submission karma, we can see it from here, from 66 submissions. This is the submission karma. And average karma per submission is around 229, and 154 is more than the average user, so the performance is quite good, we can see. And currently it's the total submission karma is around 8703, which is reported by Reddit. Comment karma also, it can be seen here. What is the best comment? Okay, this is the best comment, and worst comment is also there. What is the best submission, worst submission? So a lot of things we can see, right? And it also shows us recommendations, like we can, you know, recommended subreddits that we can participate on, and best average karma and worst average karma. So a lot of things can be seen from this particular tool, and you can use it for making your Reddit experience better. So now let's move to the second tool, which is called as Later for Reddit or toreddit.com. These two tools, actually we will be discussing two tools here, and these tools are basically used for scheduling posts on Reddit. Like we discussed in the previous video, that timing factor is really important. So if you want to schedule your post, sometimes you are not able to post according to the best times when there is more engagement. So for those particular times, what you can do is you can schedule your Reddit post. So these two posts are made for this purpose only, and these tools make your Reddit post management really easy. So you can see here, you can simply choose the subreddit, and it shows here that how you can schedule the post in a queue, just like other scheduling tools like Buffer app and Hootsuite. So, and similarly, this is another tool, which is toreddit.com. So both these tools you can try, and let me know if these work for you. So now we'll move to the next tool, which is called Reddit Check. This is basically a Chrome extension. Let me show you here. If you will search on Chrome, then this is the extension that you can add to your Chrome browser. And what this extension do is it lets you check whether the current URL you are on has been submitted on Reddit. You can jump right into the discussion if the link has already been submitted. Otherwise, a submit this link is provided for a link to Reddit submission page. So this extension will save you some time if you are about to repost a link, and also this extension is a quick way to check for Reddit's comment on a blog or article. Great. So let's try to check how this particular extension works. Great. So we have added this extension, and now let me log in Reddit.com. Great. So I'll try to see this post, and here I'm seeing something. Okay, so this is funny, and Who else has posted this? I can see it here, right? So next tool is called Mostly Harmless, and this plugin takes repost checks a step further. If the URL in question would be a repost, Mostly Harmless plugin takes you to the original post on Reddit to let you vote and comment on it. And that's just one of the things this plugin does. It also protects your Reddit browsing privacy, integrates Reddit Mail with your desktop, and supports every language Google Chrome supports. So let's go and try to find this particular plugin on Chrome. Okay, so Mostly Harmless. Okay, so this is the Mostly Harmless plugin that we were talking about. We can directly go to this link and download it, and then we can install it. What it says is that Mostly Harmless looks up to the page you're currently viewing to see it has been submitted to Reddit. Okay, so I can see that it's quite similar to the previous plugin that we were discussing for the Chrome, right? And it shows desktop notifications also, privacy feature like we discussed, here it is. And customization also, we can customize it. Internationalization is also there. So you can try using this tool and let me know, how does it work for you. Now we'll move to the next plugin, the next tool, which is called Reddit Companion. So Reddit Companion integrates Reddit into your browser, and it's basically another Chrome extension for making your Reddit marketing experience better. Easily vote, save and view comments on Reddit posts with an unobtrusive info bar. We'll move to the next tool, which is called Reddit Metrics, and it is a tool for tracking statistics of subreddits and discovering the fastest growing communities on Reddit. So let's go to this particular tool. Here it is, redditmetrics.com. They have got a website, and we're here. So now it's showing us the fastest growing subreddits. So these are the fastest growing subreddits and accounts, I think. So, and along with that, it's showing us a certain graph also, top reddits. Let's click on top reddits. Okay, so these are the top reddits with particular subscriber count also shared with us. So it makes it's easy for us to find the right subreddit, because when we discussed in the previous videos that in order to find the right subreddit, we always have to do some research that which particular subreddit has got a lot of engagement by people, and where there are more subscribers, and because where there's your audience, if you'll engage there, then the chances of getting traffic in return is little more. So here's how you can use this particular tool. So we'll now move to the next tool here, which is called Reddit Leaderboard. And Reddit Leaderboard tracks karma per user. It presents easy to understand graphs when a user is searched, as well as maintaining ranked user list sorted by types of karma. Okay, so let's go to Reddit Leaderboard. Okay, the link is karmalb.com, and let me try to find Martin Tech 123 here, and let's see what it shows. Okay, so this is a graph it's showing us, and this graph, I think it shows what does it show? Rankings. Okay, so total karma is okay, so users with highest combined karma, link karma, okay, comment karma, oldest users, okay, currently tracked, most searched for. Okay, so a lot of analysis can be done using this particular tool, which is called Leaderboard for Reddit. We'll move to the next tool, which is called Karma Decay, and this is kind of reverse image search of reddit.com. Use Karma Decay to see if images you post have been posted before or not. Okay, So Reddit Karma, they have got a website which is called karmadk.com. Great. So karmadk.com, we are here. And great. So let's browse for that particular image. Okay, now we are trying to do some reverse image search for reddit.com. Okay, no very similar images were found on Reddit. So this image can be used for posting on Reddit, and this is really cool because, you know, sometimes we, while using any particular image on Reddit, we are not sure whether it has been used before or not. So this can be used for letting us know that, and if your image is unique and interesting, then you have got higher chances of engagement. So that's a good tool, which is called Karma Decay. So now move to next tool, which is called Meta Reddit, and they have got their website, which is called metareddit.com. And what it does, it shows a list of top subreddits or tagged reddits or searchable reddits, and this talk feature lets you get a feel in what subreddit a redditor is active in. And with monitor, you can find out when a phrase is mentioned in Reddit's comments and submissions. So, you know, kind of analytic tool. Next is Reddit Enhancement Suite, and it's an absolutely must have. What people say is that RES, that's a short form as it's known on Reddit, is incredibly useful, and not only does it make your browsing experience a lot smoother, it allows you to tag users, allowing you to note who has positively responded to your post in the past. So this is kind of, I think this is okay, they have got the website also here, so let's go to their website. This is their website. Great. Okay, so they have got particular Chrome extension also, Firefox extension also. Let's try the Firefox add-on. Okay, here's the Firefox add-on. We can add it to the Firefox. Okay, so you can add it and let me know if it works for you, right? I will again say that Reddit has enormous marketing potential. If you play it right, you will generate a ton of traffic to your website and develop an active community of loyal followers to fuel your brand engagement. So use it properly if you have time. Submit things that you like, join lots of subreddits, comment on other people's stuff, and upvote and downvote. So basic engagement should be there. There is something for everyone here, so there is no excuses. I have also shared links to some case studies in the video description below, from which you can take inspiration. And I hope that our research on Reddit marketing would help you in becoming a successful marketer. So thanks for watching these videos and being with us. Thank you.